Channel Fireball people, you're back with me, Hot Chalk, and we had a busy weekend of Pokemon. Three regionals, Joinville, Indianapolis, and the Bilbao Special. So we're going to have a fun time today working out the top five deck for the power rankings this week. Let's get involved. Right, so coming in at number five, we actually have Rapid Strike Urshifu Moltres, a deck that was really high up last week, you know, with five out of top eight placements at Frankfurt EUIC. Didn't really have the greatest of weekends. One of the highest placing Urshifus, though, was piloted by Pedro Torres, and that's what this list is here that we're looking at. You know, still got the 2-2 Urshifu, which for two reasons. Number one, has that Gale Thrust attack, which is 150 damage. If this Pokemon became active this turn, if Arceus doesn't have Dunsparce out, you can actually one-shot Arceus's. Pretty cool. And then G-Max Rapid Flow for free energy. You discard all of them, then you can do an 120 snipe into places. This means against Arceus and stuff like this, you can start KO with stuff like Sobbles, Remoraids on the bench, all that good stuff. Urshifu just cleans them up, and hitting for fighting type weakness right now is really strong. I like seeing the meta champion there as well for some sneaky yoga loop action, which if you go and watch back the Bilbao stream, which I was commentating by the way, when Pedro was playing Stefan Ivanov, you actually see this yoga loop coming really handy for two energy or rapid strike energy. Put two damage counters on one of your opponent's Pokemon, and if a Pokemon is KO'd via that damage, you can take an extra turn. Really good against loads of these one prize decks, you know, in combination with this quick shooting Inteleon, which puts two damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon anyway, on one of your opponent's Pokemon. You can start to line up stuff like Sobbles, Drizzles, Remoraids, anything like this, or Dunsparce even. Yoga loop them, get an extra turn, and really get crazy with it. One thing Pedro makes really good use of here is the Cotton Lift Eldegoss for 80 HP. Lets you grab two basic energies from your deck and put them in your hand. That's really good for providing energy for the Galarian Moltres, which we've seen in countless decks right now. So you can get played in Arceus and Inteleon, because for its fiery Wrath attack, which does 50, but each prize card your opponent's taken plus 20. Meaning that once Mew's taken three prizes, you can start getting to work straight away with the Galarian Moltres. But not only that, because of its malevolent charge ability, when you bench it, you can put two Dark Angels on it, meaning you can actually get to that Fiery Wrath as early as one turn. And against everything else, you're still just one prize Pokemon that's doing a ton of damage. Worth noting here in this deck, there are a ton of one-offs that you might not actually be able to see because of the camera, so bear with me so you can have a look at them. So we've got like two Sonyas, really good in the early game because you can get either two basic Pokemon or two basic energy, meaning really good. So in the early game you get two basic Pokemon, in the late game you grab two basic energy. We even see stuff like the Cynthia's Ambition, really good for drawing up to eight cards when your Pokemon has been knocked out last turn, really strong. The Bird Keeper, that is a real good pivot for stuff like Gale Thrust, try and get your Snorlax out be active if it's there. Raihan, you can get extra energy attachments, meaning you can get to Rapid Flow in one turn. Peonia to help access your prize cards, because with so many one-offs, you might have some bad stuff prized. Peonia sorts that out for you. Cheryl to heal off your Urshifu when it's taking damage, because 230 HP is a lot, and it should be tanking hits, so Cheryl lets you reduce that. One boss. We've even seen one Avian. It's actually a really, really good card that helps you in the Arceus Inteleon matchup, because what can happen is Arceus Inteleon now playing Dunsparce to remove their weakness and playing Manaphy, so you can't Rapid Flow. And in that scenario, Urshifu becomes really neutered, right? However, with Avery, you can make them discard till they have three cards on their bench, effectively making them choose. Do they want to keep the Dunsparce and the Manaphy, or do they want to keep their Inteleons and Drizzles? Avery is pretty good for that. And then you got the Clarabuck, which is super useful for reusing the Galarian Moltres. Quite honestly, I think this might be the best way to play Urshifu right now. I really love the Eldegoss package, but it didn't really have too many good results this week, and that's why I have to put it at number five. What have we got at number four? Coming at number four, we have Arceus Beedrill, and it's actually had a really good showing in Indianapolis. A ton of top tier American players were playing it. I think such as Sam Chen, Isaiah Bradner got to the finals as well, and I think Rahul Reddy was on this deck list as well. Let me talk you through it. So this is very basically like an Arceus Inteleon shell, where you have a reduced Inteleon counter, only three Drizzles and one Inteleon respectively. But what you do have is this Beedrill here, which this attack here, Persisting, But one energy knocks out your opponent's active if they have any special energy attached. That means other Arceuses with DTEs are KO'd, and so are any Mew VMAXes with any special energy, which is pretty much all the Mew VMAXes. In combination with Single Strike Mustard, you can actually get this normal stage 2 Pokemon into play straight away. As long as you have no cards in your hand. And that's where the brilliantness of Starbirth comes in. Starbirth obviously allowing you to get two cards from your deck, meaning you can always grab something like Ultra Ball and Mustard. Making you can get your hand down to one, play the Mustard, get Beedrill, draw five cards, get back in the race. Honestly, this is a pretty crazy deck. Things I like to see as well is the one right hand, one water, meaning you can use Aqua Bullet, which is a really good attack from the Shadies and Inteleon. 120 into the active and 20 on the bench. All this damage really matters when you play an Arceus, because Trinity Nova's attack, 3 for 200 or often 180 after a double turbo, really isn't the greatest, so all the damage can add up. And Aqua Bullet is really nice in that mid to late game, making your opponent have to hit for another one prizer they probably don't really want to. So yeah, that is why it's our number 4 deck. Honestly, it's really strong. Beedrill still putting in a ton of work. What have we got on number 3? Coming in at number 3, we actually have Mew VMAX. We actually saw a couple different ways of playing it coming out of this weekend. This is Joe Perez's list. I believe we got top 8 Indianapolis Regional, so we'll get there eventually. We all know what Mew VMAX does by now. Cross Fusion Strike on the Mew lets you use any Fusion Strike Pokemon's attacks as this attack. That means you can copy stuff like Genesect 210 Techno Blast, Psychic Leap from the Mew V, allowing you to do 70 damage. Go for yourself back in, or otherwise Melodious Echo, which does 70 for each Fusion Strike energy you have in play. Honestly, Meloetta is a really cracked part of the deck, because not only if you get to 4 Fusion energies in play, your Meloetta or Mew can hit for 280 damage, actually one-shots Arceuses, pretty much all of them, but it also makes the Meloetta do 210 damage or more as early as turn 1 going second, because of Elisa Sparkle, which lets you grab 2 Fusion energies from your deck, attach them to your Pokemon, meaning you can attach one to Meloetta, at least is out 2 more, you can do a 210 swing as early as turn 1. In combination with Power Tablets and Choice Belt, you can actually start Oko and Arceus V's turn 1. Honestly, pretty scary. And that's not even to mention Genesect's ability Fusion Strike system, which lets you draw up to the amount of Fusion Strike Pokemon you have in play. So that means if you have 6 Fusion Strike Pokemon in play, you actually draw 6 cards if you have an empty hand, and if you have 3 Genesects, you can do that 3 times. You can just turbo through your deck and get some pretty crazy turns. The reason why Mew is actually so low is we didn't really see too much of it in Bilbao, but we did have a decent showing in Indianapolis, so I thought I'd put it at 3. It's still the most represented deck in day 2, but not really having that conversion into the super high tables. We did also see a Pokemon catchers list from Michael Long, which I think made top 4 as well, you know, where you can sort of catch up threats. And I think that could be an interesting way of playing it, because the way it is now, Arceus V-Star started to take over the format with 280 HP on a 2 prizer. It's honestly really exhausting for Mew to have to deal with. Sure, you've got your power tablets, just make you do an extra 30, but there's only so many of them you can play, and when you're taking 2 prizes, playing like 3 or 4, can get a little bit costly. So maybe catchers now is the way to go. Just try and take 2 prizes every turn on like bench stuff, and then maybe try and reach for 1 Oko during the game. But yeah, that's Mew VMAX. What have we got at number 2? Coming in at number 2, we actually have Whimsicott V-Star. This actually had a ton of showing in day 2 at Indianapolis, and it actually won the Bilbao Special, piloted by Alessandro Cremasoli. He hasn't released his list yet, so I'm just going to refer you to the Whimsicott list from Frank Persic in EUIC that came second. And I can sort of tell you about some of the changes, because I actually managed to commentate this deck on stream. I got to see it a lot in action. So Whimsicott V-Star is built around Whimsicott V-Star, which for 2 colorless energy, 1 psychic, there's 160, and your opponent can't attach special energy or spool cards. This is really good when you consider Arceus can no longer attach double turbo, and Mew VMAX can't attach pretty much anything unless they're playing basic energy. So before this, I don't think Whimsicott was truly a deck that you would expect to see at events, even after Frank Disavow. But I think after this weekend, we have to start respecting Whimsicott. Now I've got 2 very, very good tournament runs. Second at EUIC, first in Bilbao, and a good few placements in day 2 at Indianapolis. Not to mention Fluffball Star, which I got to commentate on stream, actually one shot a Duraludon VMAX which does 60 to one of your opponent's Pokemon for each energy attack. So you can just start stacking double turbo psychics and make this fluff ball star just like a nuke that will drop on your opponent and take a big one shot. We also see Barrel played with Rimskot a lot as well, just so you can draw up to 5 cards. Really nice, so because you might be having to start playing disruption supporters such as Marnie, you might use Industrious Incisors to help find your double turbos, stuff like this. We also see one Crobat V to help set up. Now, I know for a fact Alexandro was playing one copy of Shadow Rider Calyrex V, the basic one, but that Shadow Mist attack, which for one Psychic Energy does 10 damage and stops your opponent from playing stadiums and special energy. And what he would do against Mew VMAX is literally put a path to the peak in play so they can't use Genesect or Arceus can't use Starbuff, and then you just keep using Shadow Mist over and over and over and over again so they can never attach their energy and they can never replace the stadium. Making for a real grindy game, because Alessandro was also playing 4 Crushing Hammers, was playing some Final Waves and a whole ton of disruption stuff as well. So I think after this weekend, gotta take Whimsicott seriously. It is a scary, scary, scary deck. But what's more scary than Whimsicott to be number one? So coming in at number one, it's gotta be Arceus Inteleon, either with or without the Galarian Moltres package. Quite honestly, the format is now Arceus Inteleon focused. The deck is absolutely everywhere, taking Indianapolis, and it was by far the most represented deck in day 2 at Indianapolis and Bilbao. Getting that super consistent Arceus, Trinity Nova, you know, and Starburst, pairing it with Inteleon line, a thicker Inteleon line, you have access to the Shady Dealing so you can take Trinity's out of your deck as and when you need them, allowing you to use some powerful supporters such as Cheren's Care, which actually isn't in this list, but it's a really popular card, allowing you to remove damage from a colorless Pokemon essentially by putting it and all cards attached to it back into your hand, allowing you to reuse stuff like Raihan, Marnie, and even Path to the Peak in some lists. This list that won Indianapolis actually makes use of Galarian Moltres as well, Hooper, which is actually an insane card for Rapid Strike Urshifu, because what Hooper does for 3 energy, 170 damage, sounds pretty vanilla, but it is a dark type, and because of its ability Two-Faced, it actually acts as a psychic type as well, meaning you can hit Urshifu's for weakness and Mew's for weakness all at the same time. This list also makes use of Energy Switch and the Baby Galarian Moltres, which can act as a little bit of soft energy acceleration, meaning if you miss energy turn 1, you can attach DTE, use Galarian Moltres, Energy Switch, and buff, get back into the race. Honestly, Arceus Inteleon is by far the best deck right now, and quite honestly, we should all be preparing on how to beat it for our upcoming regionals, because Arceus is everywhere. I think in day 2 of Indianapolis, it was like, what, 70-60% Arceus decks, which is crazy, so it's definitely Arceus's format right now. Let me know what you think. Did you get to any of the regionals over the weekend? What did you play, or what would you have played? And looking at these results, what will you play moving forward? If you want to buy any of these cards from Channel Fireball, make sure to use my code HOTCHOCK. It'll help me out, and it helps you out as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.